In this topic, I would like to tell you what is the ballistic missiles and what is cruise. What are their use and the how do they perform their work? Because in the recent times, the India have tested the different kind of missiles. Some of them are cruise and the some are the ballistic. It is important for you to know because in my previous topics, I have discussed India's recent missile testing. It will going to help you to understand the topic in detail. Starting with the definitions of the cruise missiles and the ballistic missiles. First, with the ballistic missiles, the definitions is just like that. A ballistic missile follows a ballistic trajectory to deliver one or more payloads on predetermined target. The target has to be fixed before it shoots off. These weapons are guided only during relatively brief period. Most of the flight is unpowered. Short-range ballistic missiles stay within the Earth atmosphere, but intercontinental ballistic missile launched on subtropical trajectory. The ICBM, that means the intercontinental ballistic missile, can reach up to 1000 km or more, even more than International Space Station's height. The International Space Station is on the height of 400 km from surface of Earth. But the ballistic missiles can reach more than 400 km. Because ballistic missiles are different kind of ballistic missiles are there. Short range, medium range, intermediary range and the intercontinental range ballistic missiles. And now we came to the definitions of the cruise missiles. A cruise missile is a guided missile used against the terrestrial targets that remains in the atmosphere. It has to remain in the atmosphere. The reasons we will going to discuss next. And flies the major parts of its flight journey at the constant speed. The speed is constant. It has to be guided by the guided systems. By the guided system that India uses, NAVIC and the GPS. GPS is United States based. The cruise missiles are designed to deliver a warhead over a long distance with the high precision. The cruise missiles are capable of traveling at supersonic speed, hypersonic speed, or subsonic speed. India do have the supersonic and the subsonic speed missiles, but India do not have the hypersonic speed missiles. Because India is still working on the hypersonic missiles, that is why India tested hypersonic glided vehicle technology. In our next slides, we will going to discuss about the some of the differences between these two missiles, ballistics and the cruise, and why the ballistic missiles are important and why the cruise missiles are important too. The first ones about the ballistic missiles. The ballistic missiles are powered initially by a rocket or the series of rocket engine in stages. Look at the third pictures. But when they follow an unpowered trajectory that arches upward and the before descending to reach its intended target. Look at this launch things. Launch, it has been launched from the ground stations. It's out of the atmosphere after sometimes. In these out of the atmosphere things, ballistic missiles has to be powered by the rocket engine because in the outer atmosphere you do not have the oxygen. So ballistic missiles have to have some oxygen chambers within it. It will going to burn its fuel by using the oxygen within it. So when it reaches over there in the ballistic missile trajectory, it comes down and comes down with an gravitational force. So when it descended, it follows the gravitational force. It shoots off, it shoots over here, it goes up over here. It is maybe guided, but when it comes down, it is unguided because the target is fixed by the launching station. So that is why the ballistic missiles follow the parabolic path. And that is why the ballistic missiles do need the oxygen facilities within it. It's not like a jet engine. So the ballistic missiles follow the parabolic path. It goes out of the atmosphere. It reaches at the height of the thousands or the 1200 km, then comes down with the help of the gravity. And for the cruise missiles, look at the red lines. It is the cruise missiles or the hypersonic missile or the subsonic missile's trajectory. So in the cruise missiles, run on the jet engine. Sometimes in the scramjet engine and the ramjet engine, dependent on which kind of missiles the country is using, whether it is subsonic or supersonic or hypersonic. The cruise missiles is just like an airplane. It shoots up the launching stations. It follows a very small parabolic path. It ends over here and it glided through the atmosphere because it do not have the integrated oxygen tank within it. It has to burn its fuel within the atmosphere and it needs the air to cruise through the atmosphere. That is why it remains within the Earth atmosphere. It doesn't go out of the atmosphere. So, that is why the speed of the path is remain constant, because it is guided. It is guided by the satellite tracking systems. And it reaches the target with the high precisions. And it can dodge so many things. It can dodge the heights. It can dodge the lows. So, the cruise missiles are far more accurate than the ballistic one. After shoots of the ballistic missiles, it is guided up to a certain path, but after that it cannot be guided. So I hope you understand this logic. And the second difference is that for the ballistic missiles, accuracy is low. I told you that why the accuracy is low. Most of the time it is not guided. Accuracy is low, but its trajectory depends upon the gravity, air resistance and the coriolis force, the speed at which the earth is moving. The earth is moving on its own axis, but in case of the cruise missiles, things are very different. They are highly accurate to its target and it is constantly propelled through its path. And I have already told you that why it constantly propelled through its path and why it has to. And the third one is that the ballistic missile range is very high. It can go up to 1000 km and came down. So very high or very low. Because SRBM, in case of the short range ballistic missiles, that distance, it can cover a distance only a mere 300 km. But in case of intercontinental ballistic missiles, it can go as far as 12,000 km or more than 12,000 km. Some of the countries have excellent ICBMs, like the United States and the Russia. They have excellent ICBMs, but its fuel requirements, it is initial trajectory is required, but it is unpowered. That is why it reaches that much of distance. But in case of cruise missiles, it is lower. The path it cover is lower. It is only 500 to 600 km because it needed the constantly propelled and its fuel is limited. And throughout its journey, it attains its high accuracy. And the fourth one is that the ballistic missile can carry the multiple payloads, but the cruise missiles usually carry the only one payload. Developed primarily to carry the ballistic missiles, fifth one is that the ballistic missiles developed primarily to carry the nuclear warhead, but it sometimes carry the conventional one. But in the cruise, conventional is usually the payload, but the some exceptional case, it can carry the nuclear one. In case of the India's BrahMos missiles, the BrahMos can carry the nuclear payload. So these are the differences I have tried to come up with. I hope you understand all the things. And the next question is that some of the countries do have the ICBM. Not all the countries do have the intercontinental ballistic missile. Very few countries have the intercontinental ballistic missiles. And among those three countries, and these countries are Russia, USA, France, India, China, and the North Korea. North Korea is an exception. Its economy is not in the good shape, but it also have the ICBM, which is very costly. In case of the UK, those are technically submarine launch ballistic missiles. USA do not have ballistic missiles which can be launched from the land. It is all the submarine launch. So in our last topic, so we are going to come up with an conclusions. I actually came up with an conclusions, and it is just like that. I can only pray for the good fortune for our world, because in the age of the violent geopolitics, everybody wants to have the nuclear warheads. Iran wants to have the nuclear warhead. Some of the Middle East countries wants to have the nuclear warheads. So we have to forsake this belligerence. We have to go for the peace. So that is why the world has to forsake the ballistic missile program for the good of the world. And our today's question is that world first intercontinental ballistic missile. And these options are: first is R7, second is KSLBM, third is Trident, fourth is Atlas, fifth is R2PM Topol. I hope all of you understand this topic. I have tried my best to give you all the informations. So thank you very much. If anyone have any questions, you can mail me in my email address that I have already listed. Thank you very much.